the woman on platform number 8. It was my second year at boarding school and I was sitting on platform number 8 at Ambala station waiting for the northern bound train. I think I was about 12 at the time. My parents considered me old enough to travel alone and I had arrived by bus at Ambala early in the evening. Now there was a wait till midnight before my train arrived. Most of the time I had been pacing up and down the platform, browsing at the bookstall or feeding broken biscuits to stray dogs. Trains came and went and the platform would be queued for a while, and then when a train arrived it would be an inferno of having shouting agitated human bodies. As the carriage doors opened, a tide of people would sweep down upon the nervous title ticket collector at the gate, and every time is happened I would be caught in the rush and swept outside the station. Now tired of this game and ambling about the platform, I sat down on my suitcase and gazed dismally across the railway tracks. Trolleys rolled past me and I was conscious of the cries of the various vendors. The man who sold